Hello again. Thank you for tuning in to episode number 2.6 of our video series Parallel Programming and Optimization with Intel Xeon Phi coprocessors. In the previous episodes, we talked about the first generation of the Intel Mic architecture based on the Knight's Corner chip. In this video, we'll discuss the next generation Mic architecture based on a chip codenamed Knight's Landing, or KNL for short. Intel Mic products based on Knight's Landing are expected to be publicly available starting in the second half of 2015, beginning of 2016. One of the most significant changes with Knight's Landing is that it will be available in two form factors, a coprocessor attached to the PCI Express bus and also as a standalone bootable processor directly socketed on the motherboard. For this standalone version, the MIC processor will have direct access to the system DDR4 memory, so there will be no PCIe bus bottleneck for data transfer. Another new feature is that KNL will have up to 16 GB of on-package high-performance memory identified as MCD RAM technology. It will deliver up to 400 GB per second, which is 5x the bandwidth of DDR4. For the coprocessor version, this memory acts like onboard memory in first generation Xeon Phi. However, for the standalone processor version, the onboard memory has a flexible usage model. It may be used as a cache for the system's DDR4 memory. It also may be used as a flat, extra-fast memory region. Or it may be partitioned and one part used as cache and the other as flat memory region. What does it mean for developers? Of course, the difference between a PCIe endpoint coprocessor and a standalone processor means that data movement may be implemented differently in code. However, it is important to realize that users that are already happy with PCIe form factor of Xeon Phi will be able to use KNL in the PCIe form factor, in other words, as a coprocessor. Likewise, programmers that want to treat Xeon Phi as a standalone computer node can do it today using native programming model with bridged networking and virtualized InfiniBand. We will demonstrate both those usage models in this course. Regarding compute capabilities, Knight's Landing will deliver up to 3 teraflops per second in double precision, which is 3 times greater than the performance of today's Xeon Phi. This improvement is brought about by 2 factors. The first factor is that KNL will use the state-of-the-art 14-nanometer manufacturing process compared to the 22-nanometer process used in KNC. This means that more logic can be implemented within the same thermal design power. The second factor is that the cores will become smarter. KNL will be a symmetric multiprocessor with over 60 cores with 4 threads each, similar to today's KNC. However, the cores based on the Silvermont architecture used in Intel Atom CPUs will have 3x greater single-thread performance than on KNC. They will feature out-of-order execution to hide memory access better than today's in-order Xeon Phi cores. They will have advanced branch prediction, gather and scatter operations implemented in hardware, and high cache bandwidth. The cooperation between cores will be implemented in a new way. Where today's Xeon Phi uses a core ring interconnect, Knight's Landing cores will be connected by a new mesh architecture. The cores will still be coherent with each other and still can be programmed as a symmetric multiprocessor. Inside of each KNL core, vectorization will undergo considerable improvements from KNC. The vector instruction set for KNL is called AVX512, and the specifications of this instruction set are publicly available. KNL will also be binary compatible with Xeon processor instruction sets such as SSE2 and AVX. This means that executables that were previously compiled for Xeon processors and earlier versions of Intel CPUs will run without recompilation on Knight's Landing cores. However, performance of legacy vector instructions with shorter vectors is likely to be suboptimal, and for the performance-critical applications, recompilation will be needed to utilize the AVX512 instruction set. At the same time, AVX512 is not compatible with IMCI, which is the instruction set that is used in KNC. For developers, it has a very important implication. If your application relies on a high-level framework for data parallelism, such as automatic factorization or mathkernel library routines, then all you need to do is to recompile the code and it will run on KNL with AVX512. However, if your code contains low-level tuning, such as compiler's vector intrinsics or assembly with vector instructions, then you will have to rewrite that low-level code completely and optimize it for KNL pipelines. One more important publicly disclosed novelty is the integration of Fabric codename Intel Omniscale with the Manicore processor. Generally speaking, Knight's Landing will have a lot of similarity with Knight's Corner. Multiple coherent cores, 512-bit vector operations, hierarchical memory and cache structure, and potentially PCIe connectivity are common properties of today's Xeon Phi and Knight's Landing. The consequence of those similarities is that as long as developers use efficient methods of parallel programming, applications designed for the first generation of Xeon Phi currently available will scale to the next generation based on Knight's Landing. The core of this training is a discussion of those future-proof optimization techniques, exposing parallelism, using data structures suitable for vectorization, locality of memory access in space and time, and control over communication. We also focus on portable programming techniques, such as assisting the compiler with automatic vectorization, usage of high-tuned math libraries, and using parallel frameworks that allow scalability rather than hardwiring certain device properties. In this sense, techniques explained in this course can help to prepare your application for future Intel many-core architectures, such as Knight's Landing and the recently announced Knight's Hill, the successor of KNL.
Thank you very much for tuning in. In the next chapter, we will consider different programming models of utilizing Intel Xeon Phi coprocessors.